I'd like to tell you about active optical devices. So these are semiconductor materials that both emit and detect light. Obviously, an understanding of the fundamentals of semiconductor physics is critical in order to understand light emission and detection. Here you're looking at the typical band structure for a semiconductor, in particular silicon. Semiconductors sometimes behave like insulators, and sometimes they behave like conductors. And we can actually modulate this behavior, which is what makes them such a powerful tool. So we'll talk about what gives rise to band structure, what makes material a good light emitter, and what makes material a good photodetector. The next topic is light-emitting diodes. These are everywhere in our world. We'll answer key questions as how do they work, why are they different than a laser, why are they so cheap, and what are the problems facing industry. We'll also talk about the groundbreaking technology behind the 2014 Nobel Prize that Nakamura won for the blue light-emitting diode. Next, we'll talk about semiconductor lasers. Here you can see a typical emission, you can see typical chips, and you can also see a typical structure. The semiconductor laser is one of the most successful laser technologies today. You can find them for 6 cents in every CD player, and the design, fabrication, and characterization is far more expensive than 6 cents. So we'll talk about how did they get so cheap, how do they work, and what is state of the art today. We'll talk about nanophotonics next, which is the idea that if you squeeze materials down, you can essentially get quantum confinement effects that can improve their performance. You're looking at here an example of a photonic crystal where I've arranged alternating high and low index refraction materials. And so this gives rise to a band structure for light. So we'll understand how do we calculate the band structure, why is this kind of thing useful, and what are the challenges. We'll talk about detectors. So detectors are used in everything from your TV remote to light detection and ranging, or LIDAR systems, the light analog of radar for self-driving cars. I've given you two examples here, a silicon avalanche photodiode and a PIN photodiode. So we'll understand how these technologies work, what are the pros and cons, and what is state of the art. Finally, we'll talk about displays. Here I'm showing you two examples of common displays. One is based on liquid crystals. And so in a liquid crystal, it's somewhere between a liquid and a crystal. And you get to this phase by looking at the transition between solid crystalline material and true liquid form. We'll also examine another technology that's used for electronic readers. It's called e-ink. We'll talk about how these technologies and others work, what they're used for, and what is state-of-the-art technology. I hope you're as excited as I am to take this grand tour of semiconductor fundamentals, light-emitting diodes, semiconductor lasers, nanophotonics, detectors, and displays.